Who here knows this man right here? His name is Matt Lawson. He is a Melbourne-based photographer and activist. He's been very active from the beginning, advocating for freedom, standing up for our civil liberties. He's been brave and outspoken, and he was badly, badly injured on Saturday. Now, I know Matt personally. What Matt does is he tries to facilitate a peaceful environment. That's right. You'll often see Matt at the very front lines trying to facilitate a non-violent atmosphere for both the police and the protesters. He wants protesters to be safe, and I can tell you honestly, he wants police to be safe as well. Now, Matt was badly assaulted by Victoria Police. He was not being aggressive. He was shot with a certain weapon at point-blank range, a couple of different weapons. I have the footage from Matt, and then I also have an interview with him. So I'm going to first show you the footage, and then I will bring Matt on.
You're not going to do that. You're going to shoot that. You're going to shoot that. What is that? What is that? What is that? What is that? Fucking cunt! Fuck me! Fucking cunt! Do it again! Do it again! Fuck off!
They're firing rubber bullets on the crowd.
Yeah.
That's rubber bullets.
It's fucking rubber bullets in a beanball fucking bag from about a meter away.
There was absolutely no reason for Victoria Police using that type of force. Absolutely disgusting. Something you'd expect to see in a war zone, not on the streets of Melbourne, against unarmed protesters. Now, I've got an interview that I conducted with Matt a little bit earlier on. It goes for around 5 to 7 minutes. I'm going to play it for you right now. All right, we've got Matt Lawson on the line with us. Matt, welcome to the show. And first of all, how are you holding up after this ordeal?
Hey, Morgan. I'm doing okay, actually. I'm doing okay. I just quickly have to say congratulations on your 100th episode. But yeah, no, I'm doing okay.
Thank you very much, brother. Much appreciated. So, Matt, we've all seen the footage now. We've seen the horrible wound that has been inflicted. There's no doubt in my mind that what occurred was nothing less of an absolute brutal assault. But in your own words, would you mind walking us through exactly what happened and how did it go down?
Yeah, it was an interesting day. It was kind of had a funny feeling in the air the whole day. With Melbourne being in the lockdown situation, it was amazing to see as many people turn up as did turn up. Obviously, people are a little bit, not a little bit, people are very concerned with their well-being when it comes to their job security, their children, and the mandating of these jabs. So, yeah, obviously earlier in the day at Parliament, some people broke through a police line and got themselves back into marching. And then as everyone was heading up Flinders Street, I was towards the middle of the pack and I just saw that the group was sort of grouping up towards the front. And I guess my thing that I try to do at all these events is try to be a bit of a peacekeeper up the front, try to be between the people and the police and try to make sure everyone's looking after each other. I don't want anyone hurt from either side. And I don't think there should even be sides. It should be, you know, peaceful protesting is our right. And I was just trying to get up to the front to make sure everyone was okay.
Yeah, definitely. Now, I can attest, verified, firsthand experience. I know how you operate, Matt. You're a peaceful person. I've seen you multiple times and been near you multiple times in these situations. And I see you make efforts to try and coordinate within both sides. And from my view, your objective is always the same. De-escalation, keep the peace, and try to facilitate an environment that can minimize injuries and people being hurt. And that's nothing less of what I viewed you doing in this instance. But something went terribly wrong. We saw from the footage, there was what appeared to be a firearm pointed right at you. And you rightfully made some comments in relation to that firearm, and then things became really ugly and painful really quickly. Walk us through it, please.
Yeah, so I was, as I said, up at the front of the pack. I actually heard the senior sergeant or whatever he was call out, "Let's go and get these pussies." And sorry about the language, but that's what he said. And I was blown away by that. I looked across. I saw the guy holding what looked like a paint gun. And I just sort of went towards him. All I had, I obviously was unarmed. I just had my phone in my hand. And I walked towards him and said, you're not gonna do that. What is this? He's not gonna fire that. And I was wrong. He started shooting at me and the people around me. I think from that, and this is just speculation because they've gone and said one thing. I think they were shooting sort of similar to paint pellets. They said they were pepper pellets, I think. The first one hit me in the wrist here, and then one hit me in the stomach. And I kind of was taken back because I wasn't expecting it. You're always in shock. I didn't know what was in the gun. I had no idea. But I turned around and went back towards them, and I sort of said, do it again. Why don't you do it again? Because I was like, they're not going to do this. There's a crowd behind me with kids, women, pregnant women, elderly people, all these families that are desperate. And so I went back towards them. I'm still 3 meters away, still not antagonizing, still not angry. And then I got hit with the hardest thud I've ever had in my life. Someone shot with another gun with a much wider barrel. And I sort of looked into it later on. It looks like it was like a beanbag type thing or a squash ball that hit me right in the middle of the stomach. And that took the wind out of me, man. I went down. I've never had anything that painful in my life. And yeah, for that split second, I went down and I kind of had in my mind, I don't want to look weak. I don't want us to look like they've won this battle or whatever. So I just got up and sort of kept on walking, but man, it hurt.
Matt, in my view, you're a hero. You took a huge injury that day and it could have potentially been a lot worse. And when I say could have been worse, it could have been worse for you if this weapon, this projectile or whatever it was, hit you in the neck or in the temple, or even worse, if it happened to hit a child that was perhaps standing fairly close to you. So I looked into it myself. It's a weapon called a Batten round launcher and fires a 40 millimeter device or object that is described as a hard squash ball, and it has a range of 50 meters. Yet you were struck within what, maybe 1 or 2 meters? So just walk us through the pain that you felt, if you don't mind.
Yeah, I would say the closest thing to it would be if someone either ran towards you at full speed and punched you in the stomach when you weren't ready for it, or maybe if you got kicked, but you got to think of the hardest kick you could ever get, because, you know, you see these street fighters that get hit this way and they can pretty much get up straight away. I went down because it took all the wind out of me. And all I could think at that moment is if that had hit a child in the face, it would have, honestly, it would have taken all their teeth out. And I can confirm, I went to the doctors today. I was in emergency. It's actually put a 2 centimeter by 4 centimeter tear in my abdomen wall. And there's blood pooling in there as well. So I've got to keep an eye on that. But the doctor that was there said if it had hit my neck, like you said, if it had hit my heart, even just 3 to 4 centimeters higher and hit my heart, or if it had hit my groin, as horrible as that sounds, I would have been in a whole world of trouble. It would have been a very, very different circumstance. And that's the thing that I think I want people to understand is I still look at the police and I think that there's people in the forces that know the right from wrong, but there's definitely plenty in there that don't understand that. And the repercussions of this, if it had been someone else who'd been not as thick-skinned as me maybe, or a child or an elderly woman or an elderly man, there could have been a death on their hands. That's the repercussions that could have happened from what they did.
Yeah, absolutely. And what I find interesting, Matt, is that these weapons are referred to as, quote, non-lethal. But you received different advice from that, and it's very easy to see how a weapon of this magnitude, if hitting someone in the wrong place at the wrong time, it's hard to argue against the prospect of a life being lost. Now, Matt, before we wrap this up today, I just want to say that I think that you're an absolute hero. I know for sure that you were out there in the front trying to facilitate a peaceful environment for both sides. You did not deserve this. If there's a message you can put out to the public before we wrap this interview up, what would it be?
I probably come from a slightly cheesy point, but what I always say to people is try and come from a place of love and kindness and understanding. we, as a group, as a movement, I guess, we always strive for truth and for justice. And with something like this that's happened, that's what's going to happen as well. We're going to look for the truth within what happened. We're going to try and get justice for what happened as well. And I say to everyone out there, just keep speaking truth. Keep coming from a place of good intentions. And, you know, in the end, light always prevails. And, you know, Morgan, you yourself with your 100 episodes, you're always out there spreading really positive vibes and really getting great information out there. And I think everyone just keep coming from a really good place and we'll get through this.
Matt, you're an absolute legend. Thank you, and I'll catch you soon.
No worries. See ya.
See you, mate. All right, good work there from Matt Lawson. Matt, thank you so much for coming on this show. I know that I speak on behalf of our audience that we hope that you get better really soon. You're an absolute legend. Thank you for being you and doing what you do.